Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for you are amazing God. You are wonderful God. You bless your children all over the world. Yes, Lord, you are amazing, and the works of your hands are wonderful. Your great grace is upon them, and what was impossible will become possible. It will be easier for them to find the solution for every difficult problem. What was not happening up till now will happen at ease. Oh Lord, you are merciful, and you have already blessed them with their kingdom spouse. Because of your mercy, you will bring them at peace. Only in peace they will have marriage and peace in their marriage. Let their kingdom spouse, the kingdom proposal, locate them. But according to your will, let them first find peace. Let them dwell in your perfect peace before they marry. Before the proposal locates them, let your peace come upon them. Let them have peace. Let your Rhema word come upon them right now. Let your glory come upon them right now. Let your word set them free. Let the Rhema word bring them the peace. Let them know that they are first the new creation. They are the new creatures. They are not the same as earlier. Let them receive the anointing, the oil for the renewal. When they are renewed, they will receive the peace. And then the kingdom spouse, the kingdom marriage will locate them. Oh Lord, let their wedding hall locate them. Oh, let their finances to be paid be done in advance. Oh Lord, let it be a miracle. Let it be a marriage with no cost. Oh Lord God, let their wedding gown locate the bride. Oh Lord, let the costliest clothing locate the groom. Let it be your will in perfect peace. I thank you, O Lord, for your perfect peace, which surpasses all the understanding. First, let them receive the renewal of their mind. As they receive peace because of the renewal of their mind, they shall dwell in the perfect peace, and they shall be blessed with not the marriage, but the kingdom marriage. They shall be blessed not with the spouse, but with the kingdom spouse. Let their destiny husband or the destiny wife locate them. Let the godly ordained spouse locate them. But first, Lord, you will bless them with the perfect peace, the perfect anointing, the perfect oil. Let them receive the gifts of Holy Spirit. Let them be blessed with the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Let them be anointed. Let them receive the impartation of the seven spirits of God. As they remain faithful to you, as they are tested, as they are found faithful, you will bless them with peace because of your great grace. Every misunderstanding will be removed. Everything that is of evil will be uprooted out of their life. No more boundaries, no more bondages. Their heart will be purified so that they will love you more than the gold and the silver and the diamond. They will love you more than this marriage. They will love you more than the husband and the wife. They will love you more than this family. They will love you more than the wedding. They will love you more than the wedding hall and the wedding expenses. They will love you more than the money, O Lord. Let them love you more than the money. Let them know that you are their master alone. Let them receive this masterhood Let them receive the renewal of the mind. Let their mind not dwell according to the things of the world, according to the system where this marriage is mandatory. But let this marriage come to them as a favor of God. It is not because of the custom. It is not because of the tradition. It is not because of what the people are saying. It is because of your favor. Let every ungodly thing be removed far away from them, so that this godly marriage will remain holy. Let them receive holiness. Yes, Lord, holiness for marriage. Let them first become holy. Oh Lord, let them remain patient until you have done working upon their heart, their mind, and their body. Let their body be perfected, let their heart be perfected, and let their mind be perfected and renewed for this kingdom marriage. Lord, thank you for your plans are wonderful. Thank you for you want to make them fruitful. Thank you for they are the chosen ones for the kingdom. Yes, the kingdom of God. And Lord, we thank you, for you have made them perfect. You have called them both for a purpose. They have the same calling, the same purpose. They both are the same kingdom financiers. They both are the same prophets. They both are the same apostles or the pastors or the preachers, the same evangelists. They have the same calling and the same service to the Lord, the same purpose. The destiny in Christ is one. There is no evil in them. And I thank you, O Lord, for this peace. Because they loved you, now you will bless them. Because they are faithful, now you will bless them. No matter what has happened in their past, it will be forgotten. It will be forgiven. And now, because they are the new creation, they will find the kingdom marriage with the new creation, the anointed ones, the marriage of the anointed ones for the purpose of God's will, for the purpose of the children to be born according to God's will. It is not because of the lust of the flesh. It is because of the purpose of God. The kingdom marriage is not ungodly, but it is the godly and holiness, so that their bed will remain holy as they bear fruit, as they bear children for the kingdom of God alone. Let their firstborn be dedicated to you. Let them be the prophets and the prophetess, and according to your will, you will use them for your glory. This marriage is for God. It is from God, and it is dedicated to God. It is not the ungodly method. It is not the ungodly system. It is not what you see in the world. It is only because the Lord said it will be done. It is the will of the Lord. It is His mercy and His great grace. What couldn't take place up till now will happen now. It will not happen with fashion. It will not happen with ungodly methods. It will happen only in the presence of the Holy Spirit. It will not be for a show off. It will be for testimony. Yes, Lord, it is for testimony, so that both the bride and the bridegroom shall be glorified. They are your anointed ones, yes, Lord. Heavily guarded by Archangel Michael. Heavily guarded by the guardian angel. Their firstborn is also guarded by Archangel Michael. Lord, this kingdom marriage will be different from what is seen in the world, and it doesn't have the worldly perspective as well. It is completely under your wings, covered by your compassion and your love, and for the anointing, for them to bear fruit for the kingdom of God. Let no man or no woman question them regarding this marriage, because this is holy kingdom marriage. It's for holiness. What is holy is perfected by God in Himself. I thank you, O Lord, for you are wonderful God, and you have found a perfect match for them already. They may not see them, they may not understand your will, but because of your great grace, you will open their heart for this kingdom marriage. You will open their mind for the godly marriage, and their ungodly mindset and the ungodly thinking about the worldly marriage will leave them. They may have seen the marriages happening in the world, but this kingdom marriage is only for kingdom purpose. So it will happen according to the renewal of their mindset. Let it not bear any barriers. Oh Lord, this marriage is free from the obstacles, hindrances, hurdles, barriers, and full of compassion. And those who celebrate this marriage will be the angels of God. They may not find anyone on earth, but they will have the angels of God attending this kingdom wedding. Yes, Lord, both the husband and the wife, they will be your servants. You are marrying your servants for servantship, for faithfulness, and for kingdom purpose. This kingdom marriage is completely different from the marriages that are seen in the world, where there is only giving of love of God, faith of God, compassion of God, and unity in Christ. Let them receive the Holy Communion so that they will be in unity in Christ. Let them be blessed with the baptism of the water and Holy Spirit. Let them receive the Holy Communion for the perfect unity in Christ, so that they will dwell in the perfect peace, love, compassion, and unity. The marriage is for unity in Christ. The marriage is for bearing fruit for the kingdom of God. Their people may not like it. Their neighbors may not attend the wedding, but the angels of God are preparing themselves and are commanded to transform themselves and come on earth for attending the kingdom wedding. This is wonderful miracle, O Lord God Jesus Christ, because this kingdom marriage comes from heaven to earth. This is wonderful and miracle, and in the presence of God, the holiness of God. They may not imagine about this, O Lord. It is difficult to understand, but let their eyes be open now, so that they will know that the marriage they had been waiting upon is not the same as the kingdom marriage. Let their sins and mistakes be forgiven, for they looked at the marriage in the worldly manner. But now, as you bless them and open their eyes for the scriptures and for the renewal of their mindset, as you open their eyes to see you and your kingdom, they will know that they are really blessed with the compassion of the living God. and your perfect love will cast away all their fears. First, they must know that they should be blessed, anointed. And as you are always talking to your anointed ones, you will put in their heart the will of the Lord, your will, O Lord. For this marriage, they have a godly will. It's not because someone said to them that they should get married. It is only because of your favor, your goodness. It's not because the world harassed them for their singlehood. It's not because they had failures in the past. It's only because your glory is amazing, your great grace is wonderful, and you're compassionate God. Lord, I thank you and I bless you, for you are compassionate, you're wonderful, and you deserve all the praises and glory and thanksgiving. Only you are the blessed one, O Lord. Let them be blessed. Let the children's children also find this great grace of marriage, the kingdom marriage, and the kingdom spouse be already ordained for them, no matter where they are born, in which location they are born, and in which country they are born. According to your will, let them speak the languages. Let them be born in the country as per your will. And let them be surrounded by your great mercies. Because you are merciful, your mercy is great, your compassion is overflowing, and your love is unfailing. Hallelujah. Thank you, O Lord God Jesus Christ, for you never fail in your promises. It is your season, it is your compassion, it is your presence that will work upon them and prepare them for this marriage. They will find peace, they will dwell in peace, their eyes will be open for the kingdom marriage, they will see their kingdom spouse in front of their eyes coming towards them for a ministry for godly reasons. They may not be able to answer the world. They may not be able to tell the world, but because they are the new creation, they know that this is God. Yes, this is God. This time, this is God. Yes, this time, this is God. They will say, they will glorify you. They will thank you and they will say, yes, this time, this is God. This is not my imagination. This is not my lust. This is not my human nature. They will say, and they will thank you, and they will say, yes, this is my faithful God. This is my faithful Lord Jesus. They will thank you. Oh, Lord, you deserve all the praises and worship, and you alone are worthy. You're worthy, oh, Lord. You're worthy, worthy, worthy. I thank you, for you are preparing them. You're preparing their mind. You're preparing their heart. You're preparing their body. And you are uplifting them upward and forward, so that at the point of communication, at the point of meet, they will come together. Bring them to the level of contact. Because of your great grace, they have the point of meet. Let them meet according to your will, according to your time, according to your season, because your time is the right time. Your purpose is the right purpose. Your will is the right will. And they are heavily anointed, so no one can touch your anointed ones. And no one can harm your prophets, because your eyes are upon them. Oh Lord, you're jealous for them. You love them so much, oh Lord. And you deserve all the glory and praises. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father.
Oh Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want.
We thank all those who are honoring the Lord with their wealth, and for all the offerings, we bless you with a hundredfold of return. My beloved ones, if you have not yet received our Lord God Jesus Christ, if you have not yet received the Holy Spirit, we shall pray a small prayer because His repentance is at hand. Our Father in heaven, we come into your presence through our Lord Jesus Christ. And today we receive salvation. We receive Holy Spirit into our heart. O Lord, forgive us our sins and help us to be born again. We shall seek you, O Lord Jesus Christ, unto Zion. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. My beloved ones, with this small prayer of repentance, your sins are forgiven and you have received Holy Spirit within you. You shall walk the walk of righteousness.